Hi guys, I am Trisha with Insectopia, here to talk to you about the different types of insect antennae. You see, insect antennae are incredibly important. They can use four of the five senses. Sure, antennae will feel around, but there are also antennae that can smell, taste, and hear. It is important to be able to identify different antennal types when you are observing insects. An antenna can tell you if you're seeing a fly or a bee, a moth or a butterfly, even a termite or an ant. We are going to go over 10 of the most commonly seen antennae. Let's start with flies. Flies have these huge eyes, the better to see you, and these very small sausage-like antennae on the front of their face. I wouldn't want to be served that sausage. There's a hair on it. The hair even has a name. This is Aristate. Say hi, Aristate. Flies have Aristate antennae, named after the hair on the sausage-like antennae. If we were going to compare a flower fly to, let's say, a small stem nesting bee, you would want to check out the antennae. Many bees, wasps, and ants have geniculate or elbowed antennae. You can see there is a bend in the middle of the antenna that looks just like an elbow. Since we mentioned that ants have elbowed antenna, we may as well talk about what you would see on a termite's head. Termites have moniliform antenna, or beaded antenna. If you look really, really close at a termite, their antenna look like a string of pearls. Let's talk about beetles for a minute. Beetles are the most diverse group of insects and have some really interesting antennae. Capitate or knobbed antennae can be found when the end of the beetle's antennae comes into a multi-segmented knob. Lamellate antennae are also knobbed at the end, except those three pieces have the ability to open and close. Serrate antennae can be found when each segment or every other segment of the antenna is expanded, making the antenna look somewhere between a saw blade and a feather. Pectinate antennae look like half of a segmented feather, whereas bipectinate antennae look like a complete segmented feather, although both antennal types are rigid and not soft. I will admit that there are so many different types of beetle antennae that we do not have time for all of them. We still have to talk about grasshoppers, praying mantids, butterflies, and moths. The next two antennae types are very similar to each other because they are long, thin, and wiry. Filiform antennae have obvious joints at the individual segments, whereas cetaceous antennal segments tend to blend together and make the whole antenna look like a hair. You can find filiform antennae all over the insect kingdom, and roaches and many other insects have cetaceous antennae. Last but not least, we have butterflies and moths. You may have a whole episode on how to tell a butterfly from a moth coming, because there are many differences between the two. The most common and one of the easiest to see is that moths have plumose, or feathery antennae. Male moths can have very large plumes, capable of smelling the female's pheromones from over a mile away. Thank you for listening. Our buggy question is, if you got to wear one type of antenna for an entire year, which type would you choose and why? Make sure to like and subscribe for more videos like this one. Come back soon to check out our next epic insect tale.